Hey, Keith, CJ here. Thanks for sending the swing to me. I want to kind of point out a couple things to you. I mean, one, let's just talk about the camera angles. So when they're filming, this camera angle is shooting too much this way, so it's going to appear the club is going to be a little bit more inside. When they film, they want to be filming more along the angle of your hands. So they're shooting or filming more along the ball line, so if that makes sense to you. So it'll just make this one appear a little bit more inside when I draw this. But a couple things I want to talk to you about. One, and again, these lines won't be exact, but I can still tell that you have a little too much knee flex. It looks like you're just sitting down on your rear end a little bit too much. You need to feel like you can get your rear end up and weight a little bit more forward, maybe even a fraction taller in your knees. But again, I can't fully tell. As you go back here, again, the club is going to appear to be inside, but I don't think it's that much. What we're going to look at here is this right elbow. That is why your club is too long, your swing is too long. From face on here, you can see the length, but it's all because this right arm loses its width. So I'm going to attach a drill there at the end of this video that you can work on. You know, we could talk about putting a floaty, you know, something that kids wear when they're swimming, that would help create width if you just put it on your right elbow. But from there, the club works just a little on the steep side, but not bad. And I think we're going to fix that by working more on your follow-through. You can see how much your head has kind of stayed down, all right? And with that, because of that, it really looks, again, too narrow right in here. We're not getting any of the extension. Bobby kind of did a drill, you know, where you'd actually put the ball out here and you'd have to really feel like your arms extended because, and or two, even the L to L with your arms extended. If you work on those two things, actually, I should say three. One being posture, okay? Two, creating a little bit more width in the backswing with the right arm. And then three, it's a mirror image, creating width on the way through. And that's what you're going to do with the L to L drill and or Bobby's extension drill. And like I said, I'll attach this at the end. Thanks for sending this to me, buddy. And
Hi, my name is CJ Gex, and I want to give you proper extension in the golf swing. A great drill to do this is to simply take the club, place it on your shoulder, turn it back in your golf swing, and extend your arms this way. You can see the extension and the width I have at this point. From this view, if we do this, we simply turn and lift. You'll notice that my arms are extended to the sky. I've got a nice triangle here over my right shoulder, and the club face is perfectly down the line, pointed where I need it. This is a key to hitting proper shots. In golf, when people lose that width and lose that extension, you lose consistency. So use this extension drill, and you'll have a lot more consistency and power to help you enjoy this game even more. My name is CJ Gex, and today we're going to cover the floaty drill. It's not raining inside here, but a key component to distance is width in the golf swing. So what I've taken here is I've just taken a floaty that you can get at any store, and it's really what kids use, a water wing sometimes it's referred to. Width in the backswing, we want to be able to keep our right arm at 90 degrees. This is the strength of the golf swing. So all I've done is I've taken this floaty, I've blown it up, and as I swing back, this floaty will keep my right arm in front of me, and when we can keep that width, that allows us to really maintain that lag in the downswing. Use the floaty drill if you want to get more distance in your swing.